Minnesota Lynx. Joined by Brian Benefitemi and Tim Swartz, I'm Blake Suniga, and we are so glad you've joined us tonight. Minnesota will get the first possession. Right outside. Pass to Powers. McBride with the ball. Six to shoot. Down low. Shots good by Dantas.
Understanding defense is better than most. McBride's a playmaker with an advanced feel for the game.
Now here's the Shields. Vandersloot outside. Inside, Parker. Banked in off the glass.
Just the way they wanted, within touching distance of the rim.
Right outside. Pass to Fouls. Outside, Powers. Drains the three-pointer.
Spacing the floor with her long-range shooting. Powers, fantastic at connecting from deep.
Outside Quigley. Now here is Dolson. To Shields. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
And the level of commitment to Shields has. Excellent job taking on the physical defense and finishing.
Pass to Powers. Bucket is good.
Well, I mean, let's be honest. If you're waiting for her to miss when she's that open, you're going to be waiting a very long time.
Now here's Quigley. Outside Parker. Vandersloot deflects the pass. And so it looks like the Sky will retain possession here.
That pass had a little bit too much heat on it for her to make a clean steal.
Yeah, that was going to be a tough catch for either of them. I mean, these are basketball players, not wide receivers.
Chicago with the ball. It's a three-point game. Just four to shoot. It's good, and she makes her first shot of the game.
If you poll WNBA coaches, Vandersloot might be the top choice to ball handle in the pick and roll. Great handles and decision-making.
Here's McBride. Fouls can't hit.
That's a surprise. Out of character for her to miss those when the D's not right in her face.
And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes played so far. Just five to shoot, and there's the foul on the shot. She'll go to the line for two. And the foul goes against Minnesota.
Can't let Parker catch you out of position defensively. She's too good at taking advantage of opponents' mistakes.
First trip to the line for her here. This next one could give them the lead.
As the top pick in the 2008 WNBA draft, Candace Parker came with loads of hype out of Tennessee. And guess what? What'd she do her rookie year? She won MVP.
And that one drops, so they lead by one. Pass to Dantas. Powers covered by DeShields. Here's Dangerfield. Tries again and fouls with the layup.
This is what fouls brings to the team. You miss a shot, she's got you. Turning this into a positive trip down the floor.
Now here's Vandersloot. Count the basket.
Early on, nearly perfect from the floor. Just one miss on their first five shots.
Pass to McBride. Here's the teardrop, and she takes it up and lays it in.
Every year, McBride works on improving additional aspects of her game, so it's really no surprise to see her well-rounded offensive game include such a sweet float.
And it's in. Minnesota trailing. Pass to Dangerfield. Fouls. Now here's Powers. And here's Dangerfield. Launches it. And the ball out of play. The Sky will have it.
Sky.
Chicago with the ball. Pass to Parker. Here's to Shields. Up and in. Off to an efficient start. 2 for 3 from the field.
Off to a strong start offensively. She's got the touch.
Now Dangerfield. Fouls. Dantas. And so she draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot two. It's going to go on Courtney Vandersloot.
Well, Dantas isn't afraid of getting physical inside. Goes right into the defender and gets her shot off.
Yeah, it's her first trip to the line.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And she knocks down the first one.
At the free throw line, Dantas is one of the better shooting bigs, so you have to be smart when defending her.
And so she makes both from the line. Chicago in the lead. Pass to Endor. Copper. The rebound. And here are the Lynx now. Pass to Banham. Back to McBride. Now fouls. To the paint. Reverses. That's a miss. She's made one and missed one. Here's Copper. That's a miss. Her second after two shots. Right outside. Offensive rebound. Boyd with the steal. And here we go, the Sky fast break. Parker gets the bucket.
I like the recognition that we're seeing from Boyd. And she kind of makes it effortless the way she locates her open teammates.
Now here's McBride. Pass to Dantas. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist.
That's the type of lead pass we've really come to expect from her.
Here's Little. Parker to the inside. Basket counts.
They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
No luck needed. It is working for sure. 5 of their last 6 field goals, they've come from inside the paint.
Here's Banham. No scoring yet from her, but that's likely to change. Ahead. A nice shot by Boyd.
They're passing the ball very crisply right now.
Their last 3 buckets have come by way of an assist.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota. Pass to Fouls. Carlton. Now Banham. Boyd covering. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Adichanwa. Azaray Stevens with some nice D. And they have certainly been looking locked in offensively.
They sure have, staying aggressive and playing in control.
Middle outside. Pass to Boyd. Outside Stevens. Tries a three. It's hauled in by the Lynx. Now Bantam. She's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots next.
Smart fake by Fowles to draw contact and get to the line. She's such a heady player.
And she's got her first free throws of the night right here.
At the line for two.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw, no good.
It's been quite the career for Fowles. Second overall pick in the 2008 WNBA draft, and has also won multiple championships and finals MVPs.
And the second free throw, good. Now here's Boyd. Stevens, good. And the assist goes to Brittany Boyd.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
It doesn't matter how good their perimeter defense is if they keep allowing easy looks inside.
And the officials will call the illegal screen here.
Very close call there on the illegal screen.
Well, I'd go along with it. You know, to me, it didn't really look like her feet were set.
And so it's Chicago with it. 6-point lead. Pass to Boyd. Stevens. Copper to the middle. Boyd. Here's Endor. Kayla Alexander with the block. Now Carlton. Second shot opportunity. Shepherd, good.
When you pair Shepherd's length with her effort level, you end up with offensive rebounds like that.
Fast a little. Stevens with it. Boyd with it. Copper, just two to shoot. And a miss there on the triple. 7-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Now Achanwa. And there's the whistle, illegal screen.
Three turnovers so far. They've been so careless with the basketball.
They've been out of sync since the opening tip. Have to take better control of the ball.
Chicago leading. For three, but they get it back. Endor got it off in time, but it's no good. And so the first quarter in, it's the Sky up four, and we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break.
Get out and establish an offensive rhythm.
And they're finding ways to score, you know, playing well and getting good offense.
And here's Quigley. Pass to Boyd. Outside Stevens. Now here's Quigley. Here's Dolson. Five to shoot. And it's Alexander with the rebound. The Lynx trailing. And here's Dangerfield. Pass to Bantam. Alexander. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
The second she got around the pick and shook her man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy deuce. Very well done. Superb assist. She was crafty, creative, and the ultimate teammate on that play.
Here's Bantam, looking for her first basket still in this one. Pass to Shepherd. Here's Alexander. And here's Dangerfield. Boyd covering. The shot by Dangerfield, no good. Here's Copper. The shot will not fall. And Minnesota the other way now. And they're looking for some kind of spark here.
Yeah, full stretch offensively. They need a bucket.
They need to get way more disruptive defensively. They just can't keep allowing these easy buckets. You know, get a little physical, show some effort.
Defensively, that's job number one. Effort, nothing easy inside.
Now here's Dolson. And it's Alexander with the rebound. Here's Dangerfield. To the paint. Alexander's shot's good. And it's all knotted up. Time called here. The Sky decide to talk it over. Both teams making substitutions here. Quarter two and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. 2 points, that one goes in.
Whoa, the long bomb. Allie Quigley has no fear to let it fly. It's in her DNA to shoot.
Pass to Dangerfield. Back to McBride. Clock at six. Minnesota scoring again.
You love to see that offensive mindset from McBride, and fans are rarely disappointed with her intensity.
Now here is Stevens. Pass to Quigley. That shot off. Natalie Achonwa playing some nice defense.
Well, if this ball game comes down to the rebounding battle, they'll be the ones coming out on top.
They've had a strong game on that front, without question.
Here's McBride. Here's Alexander. Oh, and she misses the go-ahead basket. Outside to Shields. And she was fouled in the act of shooting, an opportunity for a three-point play.
Well, obviously, DeShields is an unreal athlete, but what makes her an all-star level player, the desire we just saw.
And she's got her first opportunity at the line here tonight.
Third pick in the 2018 WNBA draft. DeShields went on to have a terrific rookie campaign.
Here's Dangerfield. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her. For three, Kayla McBride drills it from outside.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Now, here's DeShields. 7 points in the game. Pass to Dolson. And that comes off the assist by Courtney Vandersloot.
A solid 6'5 player. Dolson has the mentality, more importantly, to be a great big in this league, not fazed by contact.
Here's Powers. He's got five. There's the triple. Another three for Minnesota.
These defenders better start closing down their shooters.
Yeah, that's too straight from long range.
Outside to Shields. Pass to Vandersloot. Dolson with it. Back to Vandersloot. Tried to answer back, but that three is off the mark. McBride outside. Over to the left wing. Outside Powers. And there's a whistle. That goes on Diamond and Fields. That's her first foul.
First personal foul. Substitution.
Stolen away. And here we go. The sky fast break. Courtney Vandersloot's got room. And she sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in.
No hesitation anymore in shooting from Vandersloot. She feels, you know, much better about her shot. Isn't afraid to fire off the pass.
Carlton, foul called that time on the way up, and that'll give her two chances at the free throw line. And first trip to the free throw line for her in this one.
Bridget Carlton, two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And she makes the first. Both shots good from the stripe. Chicago trailing here. Pass to Parker. Little. Outside Quigley. Shot clock at five. Here's Endor. Outside Quigley. Offensive board. Endor gets the bucket.
There's a pattern taking shape. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Yeah, four of their last five baskets have been of exactly that variety.
Now here's Fowles. She's got five. Dantas, right side. Rebound Chicago. That's tipped. And so it looks like the Sky will retain possession here. Outside Parker. Little outside. Six on the shot clock. Courtney Vandersloot for three. Minnesota trailing. Outside Powers. Pass to Carlton. And she drops in the layup off glass. Now Vandersloot. She's got six. That's good, and that's her fourth basket of the game. She's a strong 4-for-6.
Once you let Vandersloot get to the rim, the damage is already done. She's too skilled around the basket.
Here's Carlton. Pass to Fowles. Now here's Powers. Just five on the clock. And here's Kayla McBride from the arc. Here's Dantas. And that one's good.
Good feed by Fowles. She's normally more of a finisher, but she also has the awareness to find open teammates.
And here's Copper. Outside Parker. Vandersloot. For three. That shot missing. Fires from 18. Endor with the rebound. And a three-on-three fast break. Passed a little. That's good, and it's Candace Parker with the assist.
And back and forth we go. That bucket gives us another lead change.
And there have been too many of those to count. These teams have matched each other shot for shot, play for play.
Man, I hope this game keeps on going forever.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota.
Wise move to call a timeout right here. They need to just settle down. They've been playing out of control, and it shows with how many turnovers they've had.
To Banham.
Right here.
Outside. Five on the clock. Let's the three fly. Got a piece of it. Pushing it up. A nice shot by DeShields.
A nice fast break from start to finish.
And what a finish it was, guys. Just so pretty.
The pass, the dunk, everything.
Shot and game clock separated by five. And stolen by Diamond DeShields. Here's Boyd. It's good. The assist that time from Diamond DeShields.
Using A-plus awareness to find the wide-open teammate, DeShields doesn't mind distributing.
And here's Banham. Takes the three. Not gonna go that time. And we're through the first half of play here in what's been a good one. Sky out in front, up by five. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports. Fantastic game from DeShields in this one.
The way she attacked the rim in the first half was absolutely remarkable. Defenders need to start building walls inside, doing whatever they can to stop her from getting to the rim.
Easier said than done when she's the penetrator. Look, her speed and agility make her an extremely tough cover.
We have a close ball game on our hands as we get set for the second half to get underway. Olsen in the post, covered by fouls. Again, the miss by Diamond DeShields. And here are the Lynx now, trailing by five. Here's fouls, gets the bucket, and the foul! That one on Quigley.
A good look, it's 6'5 with her strength. It's so hard to stop fouls, even when you foul her.
This will be her third free throw shot of the game. Offense, here the Sky. 2-point game. DeShields. Powers covering. And the foul on Sylvia Fowles. That's foul number two for her. Here's Quigley. to Shields. The shot is good. Allie Quigley making the play.
Even for a player like Quigley, who is known for her ability to score, you have someone that open, you can't miss it.
And there's the call. It's going to be an illegal screen.
Good call there. Her feet still moving when she set the screen.
And she sort of lowered her shoulder into her, too. A move you perfected, actually. But they were going to get her there one way or the other.
Now here's Parker. She has six. Pass to Quigley. And she's going for the hoop here. Vandersloot shot is off.
Still cold from the field at the start of this third quarter. 1 of 4 so far.
And they pick up two.
Textbook. Nice pass. Nice catch. Nice shot.
Left side to Shields. Outside Quigley. Shot clock at six. Pass to Dolson. Oh, drew the foul and almost hit the three-point bucket, but she'll go to the line to shoot three. This is her first trip to the free throw line tonight.
Three shots.
And she's good on the first of three.
2017 was a breakout year for Stephanie Dolson. She shot 56% from the field, 44% from three-point land, and averaged almost 15 per game, making her second All-Star team.
And she sinks the second. She makes all three. And we're just around 2 minutes into the final half of play now. Pass to Dantas. Here's fouls. McBride shoots over Quigley. And that'll be Minnesota's ball as it goes out of bounds. Lynx able to keep the ball here. Here's Dangerfield. Dantas, right side. Powers, covered by DeShields. Three on the clock. Charity stripe shot. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. And there's the call on Allie Quigley. That's foul number two for her. Now here's fouls. She's got eight. And here's Kayla McBride from the arc. It's rebounded by Vandersloot.
Our offense scuffling a bit in the second half. Just 1 for 5.
And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. It's going to go on Courtney Vandersloot. And this is her first free throw of the game.
Bristol Dangerfield taking two shots.
Free throw is good. She hits both from the stripe. Now a timeout called by Chicago.
Looks like the coach saw some things out there that need adjusting, and it's going to take a little time to talk it over.
Yeah, never a bad idea to use a timeout if there's something that's got you concerned.
Yeah. right around 3 minutes into this second half. Vandersloot with it. She's got eight. Here's Quigley. Connects on the 17-footer.
That jumper, it works from everywhere on the court. Quigley works tirelessly on her shooting, and boy, does it show.
To the inside. Here's fouls. And the Lynx miss again.
It's very dangerous to leave her open like that. Lucky break for the D that she missed it.
And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, and will shoot two at the line.
Don't foul a jump shooter. It's one of the oldest rules in basketball, and Quigley certainly qualifies as a jump shooter.
This is her first opportunity at the line
shoot
this
two.
Evening. The first one falls.
Her first 4 years in the league, can you believe this? Allie Quigley didn't even average 4 points per game in any season. Now she's an all-star pouring in better than 15 per game. What a story.
He's perfect from the line this time. The Lynx trailing. Right outside. Fouls. Guarded by Dolson. Here's Dangerfield. The shot misses. Some solid defense from Brittany Boyd. Left side to Shields. Candace Parker, the open look. Sylvia Fouls comes up with the rebound.
No getting around the fact that that's a shot she has to knock down.
Pass to Dangerfield. Back to McBride. Alexander. Clock at six. Now Dangerfield. From outside the arc. She can't hit that time.
This has been a brutal day for her. She still has not made one shot. Not a single one. No wonder they're struggling.
Here's Dangerfield. McBride outside. Shoots over Quigley. And the basket by McBride.
Beautifully crafted for maximum efficiency. McBride's a natural playmaker.
Pass to Quigley. Parker on the wing, diamond to Shields. That's off the mark. She's shooting 60% on 6-for-10 shots. And Fouls gets it to go.
That pass into the paint was dead on target.
Chicago leading. Here's Boyd, outside Quigley. She scores her fifth field goal, and she's taken 9 shots to get there.
Well, you gotta like her shot selection today. She set the bar for the rest of the team.
She's gonna play her way right onto the bench if she continues to shoot the ball like she has this quarter.
Pass to DeShields. Dolson up top. Knocks it loose. And the Lynx pushing it up now. For three, Kayla McBride. That's all good. And that's her fifth basket of the game. She's shooting 5-for-11. Timeout called the Sky.
Coach thought the players were looking a little tired and called the timeout to give them a chance to catch their breath.
Boyd. Pass to Copper. Endor covered by Fouls. Here's Endor. Doesn't go for her. Now the Lynx take it the other way. Pass to Banham. Fouls with it. And here's Carlton. Just five to shoot. Let's go with a three. Achanwa picks up the foul. That is her first foul of the game. Now here's Boyd. Pass to DeShields. Stevens. Here's Copper. And it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. And she'll shoot one more at the line.
One shot.
We're still waiting for their first miss from the line this half.
100% since halftime? I'm not sure this lead's going away anytime soon.
Here's Banham. Quiet so far offensively, searching for her first points of the game. To the left side wing, Achanwa. She's guarded by Stevens. Four on the clock. Lets it go from the wing. And she tries off the glass, but it's no good. Outside Boyd. Brittany Boyd draws the double. Copper. A chance there to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark.
It's been one of those days for her. She's really struggled.
Shots good by Fowler.
It's hard to find fault with anything she's doing this quarter. Well, offensively at least.
Pass to Boyd. Makes it off the glass.
Very clever passing. She put that ball on a silver platter for her.
Now here's Achanwa. Carlton. Here's Banham. And here's Carlton. From deep, kept alive, Achanwa, and she banks in the layup.
Never gives up on a play. Achanwa likes to battle for offensive boards.
Pass to Boyd. Stevens. Here's Copper. Now Endor. Shoots over fouls, and that one goes long. Taken away. A one-on-one situation, and that one drops for her.
Well, in the open floor, DeShields plays with incredible flair. And we've seen some crazy behind-the-back passes in transition from her two, but that time she took it herself.
Again, Minnesota.
Perfect screen there. Set her up with a terrific look.
Yeah, but that's a bad job by the defender to not fight through that screen to contest.
You want to see more effort there.
A drive by Diamond DeShields. Left side Boyd. Shot clock at five. Minnesota grabs the miss.
Well, she didn't have a hand in her face, so I thought she was for sure going to bury that.
From deep. No good on the last second attempt there. The third quarter comes to a close. It's the Sky. They lead by five. And two. Not go away, as we'll be back in just a few moments for our fourth quarter of basketball coming up next. And let's take this opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
This was an easy choice tonight. Look at the precision on this pass. Put it on a platter for her.
Yeah, she served her up some tasty room service right there, guys. Sweet dime.
All right, we welcome you back to what's been a hard-fought battle. Fourth quarter should be good. Now here's Powers. Here's Dangerfield. stopper. Pass to Endor. Now here's Vandersloot. And here's Dangerfield. Got a hand on it. Here's Copper. Vandersloot with it. Powers covering. Pass to Copper. 60 ticks off the clock here in the fourth. Right side Powers. Good on the bucket.
Laser focus from Powers. The bump not affecting her shot.
Vandersloot with it. The floater. Count that bucket. Here's Powers. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus.
Pass to Shepard. Looking to get back on track. Now Dangerfield. And there's a whistle. That goes on Diamond Field. That'll be her second foul of the game. So both teams changing it up here. And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth here. Pass to Dantas. And again, no good by Minnesota. Here's Quigley. And that's out of bounds. Chicago will retain possession.
In from the sky, Candace Parker.
And so it's Chicago with it. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Stolen by Natalie Achonwa. McBride left side. A touch under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Dangerfield. The 3-pointer off the mark.
Now talk about hurting your team. She just can't get anything to fall out there.
Dolson. And so she earns a trip to the line. Official saw the contact, and she'll shoot 2.
The mobility of Dolson coupled with her size, it's very difficult once she gets inside to stop. Sometimes you have to foul.
Shooting 2.
And the first one at the line is good. So she hits both of them. Minnesota trailing. Outside Achonwa. Dantas. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
Passing, not exactly her calling card, but Achonwa doesn't miss open players. Good eye.
Pass to Quigley. Good work defensively by Kayla McBride. Powers, no good on the 3. And here's Copper. Back to Quigley. Pass to Dolson. Shoots over Powers. Dolson, shot's good.
It's really a sign of a great player. Doesn't let a bump here. Contact there. Stopper. Nice job by Dolson.
Here's Dangerfield. Vandersloot defending. That one goes. Count it. Chicago in the lead. Now here's Vandersloot. The 3. The rebound by Dantas. And aerial Powers. Here we go. Pass to Vandersloot. Back to Parker. And she uses the glass on the layup.
No doubt, Parker's a player who can score from range. But what makes her so deadly, at 6'4", she can just dominate it inside.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota.
Yeah, I think the head coach saw too many easy buckets coming from inside. Wanted to put a stop to it.
I would think so. If they keep giving up the kind of easy looks inside and that they have been, they're in big trouble, Tim.
And they've got to change something up. Let's see what they do.
Out to the left wing. McBride outside. Fouls. Guarded by Dolson. Offensive rebound. Dontis's shot is off.
If she can get to the rim, she'll usually turn it into points, but the defense stood tall there.
Well, they're winning despite her errant shooting.
And they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
Puts everything on the court. Now, McBride will risk her body and mind every day for the good of her team.
Now a timeout called by Chicago. Now Quigley fires it, and it's rebounded by Sylvia Fowles. For three, Kayla McBride. No luck on that one. The Sky go the other way with it. Courtney Vandersloot attacking, lays it up and banks it in.
Dangerous on the drive. Vandersloot uses her burst to get to the rim and her touch to finish at the rim.
McBride outside. Inside. That comes off the assist by Sylvia Fowles.
All quarter, she's been zeroed in, locked in, focused, and she's knocked down big shots for her team in the fourth.
Outside Quigley. Pass to Dolson. Shoots over Fowles. And it's Dolson missing.
She operates well in traffic, but still a tough play to finish off.
Ariel Powers on the wing. The three-pointer is on target.
With the level of shooter that Powers is, letting her catch it fire, it's not a recipe for success for the defense.
Pass to Copper. Outside Quigley. Here's Parker. Copper. Powers covering. No good.
Some of the shots she's taken today have been absolute head scratchers. She's out there playing like it's a game of horse, and it's not.
And that one's good. Fouls.
Given all of Fouls' big game experience, there's just no way she feels pressure in big moments.
Now a timeout called by Chicago.
Well, the coaches, they clearly don't like what's going on there, and they want to talk things over.
And why wouldn't they talk things over? I mean, really, you had to take a timeout there and just try to take away some of the opponent's momentum.
Thank you.
outside. Kicks it out to DeShields. Good for her 8th field goal. She's attempted a dozen shots.
It's DeShields answering the call. When it matters the most, Diamond shines the brightest.
Here's McBride. 8 for 15 with that basket, but she's not satisfied yet.
The vocal and emotional leader of the team. McBride's squad is in good hands when she has the basketball.
Shooting two.
And the first one drops.
After being named an all-star during her rookie campaign in 2011, Courtney Vandersloot didn't go to another all-star game until 2019. Just goes to show you she stayed hungry throughout her tremendous career.
And that's good as she hits both shots.
She's the player you want at the charity stripe in that situation. I got no doubt about that.
Ariel Powers on the wing. Pulls it from 20 and misses it off the right side of the rim.
They didn't give her any breathing room to take that shot, and that's exactly what they should be doing.
They get the rebound. Count that one.
Well, when I think of Candace Parker, the first thing I think of, winner. She loved these moments.
They double her with Dolson. Fouls can't get it to go. Chicago in the lead. Here's Vandersloot. Rejected by Kayla McBride. Quigley shot's good. And here are the Lynx now. And here's Dangerfield. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two. Stephanie Dolson picks one up.
Shooting for your Minnesota Lynx. Crystal Dangerfield. At the line for two.
Two.
So the first one drops, and that brings them within 5. Good on both.
Absolutely flawless trip to the free throw line, and that gap just got a little narrower.
Vandersloot outside. In for her 7th make in 13 attempts.
With ice in her veins, Vandersloot remains calm and collected in clutch moments.
Time called here. The Lynx decide to talk it over. Official signals a jump ball there. Chicago with the ball. Here's Parker. Outside to Shields. Vandersloot. Back to DeShields. 4 on the shot clock. No good that time. excellent D there from Sylvia Fowles. Here's Powers. Buries it. And now they trail by just four.
You can see Powers is in the zone, not allowing any distractions when it comes to making the clutch shots.
And so they foul intentionally.
Yeah, they had to do that. You just can't let them dribble it out.
Definitely. Got to stop the clock any way possible.
Shoot two.
Just hope they short arm a few of their free throws.
It's a good foul, and it's a good point in this situation to make them hit their shots.
He hits the first one, and that puts them up five. So she goes two for two at the line, and it's a 6-point ball game.
Now that's how you close a game out. Those free throws will bury them for sure.
Now a timeout called by Minnesota. What's your take, guys?
Yeah, I don't think a 2-point basket does much good for them here.
Yeah, I think that's their only choice, a three and then a foul.
Just not enough time left.
Here are the Lynx now. They trail by six.
A prolific scorer whose clutch shots make the crowd go wild. McBride's presence of mind is remarkable.
And now an intentional foul. They need the ball back as soon as possible.
Shoot two.
He gets the first. And that gives them a 4-point cushion. Second one is good, getting both at the line. And it's a 5-point game.
That was a critical trip to the stripe. They have a 2-possession lead now.
McBride misses. So it's Chicago picking up the win. So that's going to do it for this one, folks.